It is a Halloween wonderland at the Minnesota Zoo right now. Thousands of jack-o'-lanterns line the quarter-mile walking trail, each one carved by hand. And we are happy to welcome the zoo's Zach Nugent and the pumpkin carver, who is Edward Cabral, to the show.
Yes.
Welcome.
You've been working on this since...
How long this morning? When did you get here?
Well, I started carving it about 8 o'clock this morning, but I drew it last night. It took about another 2 hours.
Wow. And you can see just the intricate detail that's going on here. So, Zach, tell us about the pumpkin carving spectacular.
It really is spectacular is the only way to put it, because what you're seeing now when you come along this forested trail lit up at night, it is a whole different experience.
Okay.
And like you mentioned, we have about 5,000 individually carved jack-o'-lanterns along our trail. And about 125 of them are these large intricates that take artists like Edward 20 or more hours to carve.
20 hours to
carve? Yes.
Yeah.
And they really are, they're pieces of art.
So for me, it takes like 15 minutes and then I'm done. I have to, you know, move on to something else. This is a lot more intricate. So.
Yes.
How do you like stay involved with the whole process of carving these pumpkins?
Well, so the whole show is set to skits, and so the artists that we have working there will pick images that work well for their style, things that look very dynamic. And so if they're interested in the images, then it makes interesting pumpkins. So we sort of start with the image, we draw, and then we go from there and we carve it and we illuminate it.
And this one, you know, has got the tiger on it.
Big
and
tiger.
It's not just, you know, just the silhouette of a tiger. You actually have the stripes going on, right?
Absolutely.
And so when you guys light this up, I mean, what will it look like in the end?
So these pumpkins, they glow like lanterns when they're lit up. So we use the ink to block out certain parts. The orange becomes like a mid-tone, and then we carve away for the highlights.
Right.
So it really has this, like, we sort of like glowing egg or like dragon egg kind of, you know, they're really quite beautiful and hard to describe.
So Zach, when families come to this, I mean, what can they experience when they go on this quarter mile trail?
Yeah, I mean, this is really a family friendly fall tradition, and we are so excited to have it back for a third year. But we have lights and music, we have the fog going, so it really sets the scene. You're connecting with nature in this beautiful fall weather and just seeing something that is absolutely spectacular. And so all of our tickets are online in advance, but we have entry each night 7, 8, 9 p.m. and then an additional 10 p.m. on weekends as well.
Okay. Excellent stuff. So this doesn't go just through Halloween, right? This continues into November.
It does, because fall doesn't end at Halloween. So we go through November 7th. So we have that extra week after Halloween if you want to come and really experience this, because it isn't just about Halloween. This is a full fall event. A lot of the pumpkins are going to be represented or shown different elements that are attached to the zoo. So animals that we have a conservation connection to, or different pop culture icons in Minnesota. So it really is something you won't want to miss this year.
So Edward, for people who are maybe carving their own pumpkins this year that maybe want to get more intricate with their jack-o'-lanterns, more than I do, do you have any tips for people?
Absolutely. So if you're doing a jack-o'-lantern face, you always say it has to have pupils, has to have teeth, give it a little bit of character, have it looking in directions, a smile or a frown. Things like this, you know, we use the black and the carving, so look for some mid-tones, some gray scales and things like that.
Okay, and it's not just like cutting through to the center right here.
Not at all.
See, like, this one is not even hollow right now. I mean, so can you just take away part of the skin to get that same lighting effect?
Absolutely. So like I said, the skin itself, it grows like a lantern. So when you just shave away that red, it really kind of highlights these, like the hairs and the sort of texture, the rats, the eyes, things like that, you know. It is gutted right now currently, but we don't cut it out all the way because we're trying to make these things last as long as possible, given the time it takes. So we have about a week once we finish these things, once they're gutted, until they go down.
I suppose once the temperature, you know, gets cool enough, then that maybe sustains it.
We are ready for cold temperatures, absolutely. We would love that to happen.
Yeah, not the 80 degrees that we're going to be seeing today. All right, so the Jack-o'-Lantern Spectacular is open nightly at the Minnesota Zoo. It is through November the 7th. Again, all tickets must be purchased in advance online, and we have a link to care11.com. So, Zach, Edward, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thank you.
So much.